ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Rome
and Jimmy Beck,
and this is the 23rd episode of Gospel Ride Along. So Pastor Beck, would you please tell the audience out there just a little bit more about yourself?
Yes, I'm the pastor at one church here in town. We meet all over the place, and so it's appropriate to be talking in the car, right? Because that's sort of what we do.
Come on now.
We move all over. And I'm from Hartsville, grew up here, was a teacher and coach for 17 years, okay. And sort of my passion and vision was that a lot of my kids didn't like going to church, students, it is. And there's a lot of great churches, I don't mean that. But they just weren't plugged into church, and so the idea was to do church in a way that would make sense to them. And it sort of grew and became its own thing and blew up in a good way. And so we're just sort of along for the ride and really enjoying it. I never thought I'd be a pastor. My dad's a pastor, but I don't really like speaking in front of people. It's not like something I enjoy. I'm sort of an introvert, but I feel like that's what God called me to do. So
awesome.
Here we are hanging out with a true extrovert. You got a gift I don't have, like, for connecting with people. So anyway, I'm glad to hang out.
Well, I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're here. As always, ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe to the channel. Because if you're not subscribed to Rome's World, then what planet are you from? Now let's go ahead and get into this episode. As always, we do have our mask and hand sanitizer just so we can all stay safe through this pandemic. Now, without further ado, it's only right that we go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Father God, Lord, I just want to thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be back here for another episode and allowing me to be here with Pastor Jimmy Beck so he can give a strong message today. Father God, I pray that you let us decrease and let you increase within us so we may give somebody a strong message and just listen to some good worship music while we're riding. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now let's see what you got on the list for us first. Let's see. Okay, Graves into Gardens.
Yeah.
Elevation Worship.
Never enough. Then you
there now.
I like it when you think it's over, and it's not over. Yeah, it just keeps going. Anyway, that's cool. It's sort of been one of the things that's been coming up in my mind a lot is how God takes bad things and turns them into good things. And it's not just like the big things in life, it's little things. You know, it's like over and over. You know, like we celebrate resurrection at Easter, which is the idea that, you know, Jesus died and was raised again. But man, I don't know, the reason that song gets me so much is that's like the resurrection is the story for every believer, like over and over again. You know, it's like your addiction's a bad thing, but God somehow sets you free from it, and then he turns your story into a good thing. And he takes that grave, you know, because addiction's nothing but a grave, and only he could turn it into a garden. Mm-hmm. Who else could turn that into something beautiful?
Come on now.
I had a student, I used to coach basketball, and a former player of mine that got in there was an accident. And anyway, long recovery, and man, just really kept hit. The word that kept coming back in mind is, this is like a little picture of resurrection, because it was like his mobility was taken, his life was almost taken, and it's not that he's just going to come back from it, and I believe he's going to be able to walk, but it's not that he's going to go back and be just what he was before. He's going to be more than he was before. Because it's, you know, God doesn't turn a field into a grave and then back into a field. He turns a field into a grave and then into a garden. It ends up better than it was to start with. And so anyway, I love that song. And I love it that just when you think it's over in your life, wait, because there's another verse coming.
And that's why, and I'm glad you brought that up, because that's when you said that, I noticed that about the songs too, is that I love songs that you think are over, but they're really not, because that reminds of, just like you said, the resurrection of Jesus. Yep. That's not how the story ends, with Jesus just on the cross. The story continues, and it keeps going, and it keeps going, and it keeps going, because our God keeps going. Yep. He never stops. No matter what we're going through in life, we know we can always call on his name to get us through, because he's the one who put us there in the first place, because he wants us to understand that it's okay to feel vulnerable. It's okay to be upset. It's okay to be in a bad spot. Because without those bad spots, you won't need God. Because God will put you in a position where you have to do nothing but call on his name.
Yep. I think he turns even your sin, once you're a believer, he reverses it. It's like, you know, sin's supposed to be a trap the devil sets for us. But it's like once you become a believer, even when you sin, it's almost like he reverses the trap. And he traps the enemy himself, because he brings us like to a place of forgiveness, you know, asking for forgiveness. And it's like, man, do we wish we would have sinned to start with? No, man, I wish I wouldn't sin to start with. But now I've been forgiven. And it's like my worship has even grown more than it would have if I wouldn't have sinned. Not that I'm supposed to anyway. It's kind of like Paul says, should we keep on sinning? No, no way. But still, that there's nothing whenever Jesus is involved. There's nothing that's so much of a dumpster fire that God can't turn into a garden.
Come on now.
And, you know, I just, in like little ways and big ways, you know, and we can sing that song. We can sing that song at a person's funeral. We can sing that song at a high school graduation. Mm-hmm. You know, we can sing it because this is the story of life. The big losses and the little losses. We got traffic stopped ahead. School bus. Speaking of graduation. Kids in school in June. Thanks, COVID. It's messed up.
But yeah. Yeah. I agree with everything you're saying. And as a testimony that I can give is that, like you said, there's some things that I've done in my life that I'm not proud of. But I know that there was a plan behind those things. Because I always tell people all the time, if I didn't go through what I went through, or have done the things I've done, I never would have seen the error in my ways and wanted to seek God and know His word more.
Yep. Yeah,
I never
absolutely
would have done that.
Yeah, so I don't know. That's been a theme, that word resurrection. I love that picture of grace in the garden. I think that's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. We're going to go ahead and keep on going. Up next, you got Move Your Heart, Maverick City.
Thank you.
There, man. One is I just love Maverick City music because you can't really tell what it is. Is it gospel? Is it like contemporary? Is it, you know, what is it? And I like that because I wish when people looked at the church, you know, sometimes they look at us and they see like there's all the same kind of people that go in these buildings on Sunday mornings together, which is sort of what everybody expects. But I wish people looked at the church. They'd be like, what is that? You know, what is that where all these different things come together? I can't exactly tell. Are y'all a white church? Are y'all a black church? Are y'all a Baptist church? Are y'all, I just think it's a beautiful thing because it sort of paints that picture of what we should be. And that song's, you know, so in leadership, there's always this trap that you start, I don't know, like, you know, I don't mind people calling me pastor. Definitely, I don't mind that. But I always want to stay Jimmy, you know, because I think what God's after is he's after just a simple, humble, obedient version of Jimmy, you know? And I don't want to ever become like a parody of myself. Yeah. And it's just simply after seeking God. I love that because it sort of brings you back to that. It's not about the performance. It's not about some external goal that you set. That God's blown away whenever a simple human being like me or anybody, with whatever baggage we bring, just worships, just as obedient in what we do, whether it's in front of one person, 10 people, or 5,000 people. That's, I don't know, that's just really grounding. And again, I love Maverick City Music, but that song really speaks to me, especially I think it's good for leaders. That's a good song for leaders, because there's this trap, you know, where we think it's about things other than just being obedient where we're at right now. And then we think to be a success, we got to do some other things that maybe God has planned for us, maybe God doesn't have planned for us. Mm-hmm. It doesn't really matter. All that, just being faithful in the moment. Anyway, yeah, that's sort of what that song, that's why that song hits home with me.
And I love that song. It doesn't just leave any one person out. Mm-hmm. Like in the lyrics, you can hear that he's telling everybody what type of person moves God's heart.
Yep.
What type of person moves his heart. And notice how in the song he doesn't just talk about just one person. He doesn't just give an explanation of something he is. He goes beyond the expectations and he talks about people who have, and notice how he pointed out the people that have imperfections first.
Yep, yep.
Because those are the people who need the saving. Though, well, not saying they don't, they need it the most. Everybody needs saving. Yep. But notice how he went to those people who had those imperfections, because you know, people feel like we're so imperfect that we have to put ourselves down, and that's not the case.
Yep.
I said in my last episode that me and my friends at school, we love when God put us at our lowest point, because we know there's no other way we can go but up.
Yeah.
All you have to do is call on his name.
You know, the first person to see Jesus after he was resurrected was Mary Magdalene, who was defined by being a prostitute before she met Jesus. And that's who God chose to be the first one there. And so, yeah, and anytime the gospel's pointed at hurting people, there's always going to be an audience to listen. Mm-hmm. Anytime we start preaching to perfect people, well, that's probably a recipe for a disaster.
Well, yes.
Long song. Sorry about that.
No, I love it. Yeah. I love it. Like, I was just about to say right now, y'all, I'm about to put that on my playlist. Y'all go ahead and comment down below what y'all gonna do with that song. Because like I said, that song spoke. Like, that song really did speak to me, because especially when it talked about the person with sin. Because we're all sinners in our own right. And you know, sometimes, like I said, we beat ourselves down because we don't feel like we're worthy enough to come to the Lord for help. We feel like we're too much to come to him. We don't want to be a burden. But see, God is our burden bearer. He wants us to call on his name. He wants us to come to him for help. You see, sometimes we get so caught up in the world that we want to do things on our own, and we try to be God, but we can't be God. We can't do the things that he do for ourselves and for other people. So that's why it's always important that when you get time, or even it's most importantly, just make the time.
Yeah.
It ain't nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes. Nobody's saying you got to give a whole day or a lot of hours. You know, just it doesn't take nothing but 3 seconds to just say, Father, I thank you for just giving me everything that I can desire in the moment right now that we're in. Because I know some of us are still trying to get through the pandemic. Some of us have lost some loved ones. Some of us have lost a lot during this pandemic. But look at you, you're still here. And because God's saying he's not finished with you yet. So if God don't give up, we can't give up.
Yeah.
But yeah, Pastor Jimmy, I like that one.
Yeah.
But we're going to go ahead and keep it going. Going on to Isaiah's song.
Future, who can know these things?
So don't fear, I will be your song. Sing it louder. Sing, sing, oh barren land. Water is coming to the thirsty. Though you are empty, I am the well. Draw from me, I will provide. I will provide. I'm the well of living water. Never run empty, never run dry. Oh, this is the word of the Lord, your creator. Say, I stand from age. I stand from age to age, the ancient of days. I'm the Holy One. Sing it out. I am the Holy One, the fairest of 10,000. And all who call, and all who call upon my name, they shall be saved. So don't fear, don't fear. I will be your song.
Oh, See, see, oh, Maryland,
that, you know, this year, you said it leading into this song before we played that one. There's so many hurting people. I mean, there's always hurting people, especially coming out of COVID, all the loss. And I just feel like a lot of people feel out there, they're in a desert, you know?
Yeah.
And they don't see, they think it's so dry now that there's no hope of new things springing to life. And so that song really speaks to that. I think it's really, like, appropriate for the season that we're going through.
Yes.
You know, the hopeless. Actually, when you get to your lowest point, to your most hopeless point, sometimes that's the greatest offering to bring.
Yes, yes, yes. And I like that word that you use, season, because everything in life is seasonal. Nothing's permanent. Everything is seasonal. You may find yourself in your winning season. You may find yourself in your losing season. But God is going to get you through. Like I say all the time, it's God is going to put you in situations where you have no other choice but to call on his name, because he wants you to understand that nobody got you out of that problem in that situation but him, because he wants you to use your testimony to help somebody else.
Yeah, 100%. And you see that story. So I love that line too. You said something about it, that when I get to the end of me, basically time just for the beginning of you to show
yes,
up.
Yes, come on. I love it. I love that. Yeah. I love that. When I get to the end of me, it's just the beginning for you. That's powerful.
It is.
That's powerful. That's I'm just gonna let that marinate in my spirit. And I want y'all to let that marinate in your spirits too. I know somebody else out there just had a mm-hmm moment. I know somebody else, not besides just me, just had that moment. I just that I'm gonna have to write that down somewhere. Because when you listen to worship music, gospel music, and all the other genres that are out there, you know music connects to the soul.
Yeah.
It connects to the soul. And it's so important. That's why they always say you must guard your eyes and your ears, because what you see and what you hear can play a big impact on your life. Mm-hmm. And it's these songs right here that we're listening to. Each song just has something so great about it, especially for me, this song. Because like I said, I listen to Maverick City as well. And this is a new song that you have just put me on to, as a young kid. So you put me on to this new song. And like I said, I love that line. When I get to the end of me, it's just the beginning for you. Because as we always say, God is getting ready to show up and show out. Because like I know some people are out there who are sitting at home watching this, or wherever you are watching this, you may feel like you just can't do no more. You may feel like that business that you want to start is not going to be successful. You feel like you are never going to be able to accomplish that big dream that you had since you was a little kid. But I'm here to tell you right now that it's possible. It's possible. Because just when you get to the end, that's when God is getting ready to show up and show out for you. Because he just waiting on that one moment. You see, like I said, we try to do things ourselves all the time. Just ourselves. We don't want nobody else help. So you know what? God gonna sit back and let you do it. But it's like when you get to that last bit, when you get to the end of you, and you just say, God, I'm tired. I need your help. Boom. God is getting ready to show up and show out in your life. Come on now, somebody.
Good stuff.
Good stuff. I'm telling you, that's some good stuff right there. And I love it. I just can't say it enough how much I love it, because y'all just don't know that the blessings that God has for you out there is so much bigger than what you have right now. You see, a lot of us feel like we had these goals that we wanted to accomplish when we reach a certain age, and we feel like, well, God, I done everything you asked me to do. I feel like I missed something. I feel like I'm late. I feel like I'm doing everything behind all my other friends. I wanted to get married by 25, all my other friends done got married at 23. I feel like I'm late. Everybody else done got their successful business by the age of 19. Here I am, 30, still trying to get it. God said, you're not late. You right on time. You right where I want you to be. You right where you need to be. So for those out there who are feeling that, just remember this song. Go back in the comments down in the section and look this song back up and go listen to this song. And remember that phrase. When I get to the end of me, it's just the beginning for you. And y'all, we done reached that mark. So we're going to go ahead and end this episode with Jireh.
I love that line in there where it says, you know, basically, you give me, I don't say it right, you give me everything I need, because Jireh means the Lord provides. Mm-hmm. And then it basically goes back and it says, just when you tell me you love me, just by doing that, that's actually everything I need. Mm. You know, it's nice that I have all the other stuff, I mean, God blesses with all kind of cool stuff, but being loved by God at the end of the day, mm-hmm. is saying God's provided. Like, he's got, like, he's given us everything we need, no matter what our circumstances are. And just to be honest, just the music in that one's so big.
Yes, yes.
You know, yes. It's just so powerful. I love it. I love it. And it's got like the call and response part too at the end, where she sort of gets the head up.
I love it.
It's got like different styles of music, and you know what I'm saying? He's sort of leading it early, and then it's got the call and response toward the end. I don't know. It's got a huge sound. It's amazing.
I just love how, like you said, everything with the words and the music go together so well to create that emotion.
Yep.
Because that's all music is supposed to do, is to make you feel a certain type of way. And that song makes me feel grateful, knowing that God will provide.
Yep.
It makes me feel so grateful that no matter what I go through, God will provide.
Yep. But you can know it and not feel it.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, you're right. It does. It sort of music hits home in a way that, you know, spoken word can't. Because I think God's designed it for a purpose, to fill that space, to help us feel things that we need to get us through our lives. So yeah, it's good. Man, I enjoyed it. That's fun.
Yes, yes. And y'all, we have reached that mark. So without further ado, I just want to say thank you, Pastor Jimmy.
Thank you, man. I enjoyed it.
Come on now, because you came and you showed up and you showed out.
Yeah.
There were some good songs.
Yeah.
Some great songs, actually.
Well, I didn't sing them, you know. I don't really sing, but I can listen to it. I know it when I hear something good, something strong. So that's really touching, man.
Yes, yes, indeed. And like I said, man, I hate that it's over, but we're gonna have to get you to come back.
Hey, man, thanks for letting me come on.
No problem. Yeah. No problem.
I feel like, man, big time now.
Oh yeah. Oh, and it's coming.
Okay.
It's coming.
It is
coming.
I believe it.
It's coming. And here at Rome's World, we just want to give you a little token of appreciation coming and giving time out of your day to do this episode, because I know you're a very busy man.
Oh, man, that's awesome.
And like I said, you this episode ran like just like the last pastor that we had, Pastor Eddie Davis, on his episode.
Mm, yeah.
You came and you brought the message, and the message was strong. And these songs, I really love every song that you chose, because it's just so powerful that how the songs with the lyrics and the music go together so well. Like I said, it creates that emotion that makes you want to just say, you know what, God, you are enough. You are all I need to get through in this world we live in today.
Yeah. You got a gift, man. Keep using it.
Thank you. Thank you. So, Pastor Jimmy, would you mind praying us out?
Yeah, that'd be great. Father, I just pray for every person that's watching this right now, that you bless them. God, if they're going through a season where they feel like they're in a desert, that you let them know that you bring fresh things out of desert seasons. Whenever we get to the end of ourselves, it's the beginning of you. And God, the beginning of you is way more than the end of us, than all of us, than any of our hopes and dreams. And so maybe somebody's holding on, just trying not to get to the end of themselves. I pray maybe right now they would let go and realize they are the end. They got nothing left to give. They got nothing left to get from themselves. And so, Father, that's the space where you step in and you do something awesome. So I pray that you do that in the lives of people watching and listening right now, and that you just keep blessing Jerome, helping to use his gift for connecting with people through music and through other ways to encourage people and really just make the world a better place. I pray all that in the name of the one that walked out of the tomb, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
All right.
And as always, I'm Jerome.
I'm Jimmy.
And this has been Gospel Ride Along.